Hello students, I am Sachin Prakash and I teach and mentor students in chemistry for IIT JEE. I believe that the real confidence which is required to crack this IIT JEE exam will come only when you are confident in tackling good problems. And that clarity and understanding of concepts will only develop when you are really comfortable in handling these problems. So this video contains the paper discussion which I have recorded conducted in my classes online. Okay, and a lot of good doubts are there which I have discussed here. It will be helping you people in understanding, developing an understanding in how to approach and tackle good problems. Okay, and if you like this, you found this paper discussion video to be useful and interesting, you can like, comment and subscribe to this channel, which will surely motivate me to add some more useful paper videos of this type. Okay, because ultimately it's this is just an effort, honest effort, small honest effort from my side to help the student, help my students as well as other students also in their IIT JEE preparation. So let us begin with this paper discussion. Okay, so we are now live and today we are going to discuss WTM 21. Okay, and this paper is based on Ashkin's complete. Okay, and this is a main study paper, so there the usual 25 questions with 20 questions of the format of single correct, and last 5 questions are like multi correct. So as usual, not multi correct, numerical value. So we'll be starting with the last 5 questions first. Okay, because these are good questions. So 71 and 72, any doubts?
72.
In 72, the answer should be 2 because they're asking
what the yes, sir.
Products. Yes.
The only 2 products are possible, CH3CHO and this one. Okay. So both are the, so only 2 products are possible, not number of moles. Okay. If they have asked number of moles of optically inactive products, then the answer would have been 4. Is it clear?
So yes.
Key change. Okay. 71 is not a doubt. Is 71 also a doubt? Yes or no?
So can you explain?
Yeah, definitely. Okay, so you see in 71, first draw the alkane. So you see you have to draw cyclohexane. This is cyclohexane. At third position you have this and you have Br. Okay, now what are the beta hydrogens? I would ask everyone to just shut down your, yeah. So what are the beta hydrogens? This, this and this. Right?
Yes, sir.
So A, B, and C. Let us draw all of them. Okay. First A. This double bond is coming here. Now this will have cis plus trans or E plus Z, whatever you want to say. Right? Yes or no? Double bond, you are having
yes,
two
sir.
Different groups. Okay, then number B, you'll have something like this. This. And again, you can have E plus Z here also. And third is C. In this case, you cannot have E plus Z because both groups are same on the sp2 carbon. From both sides, you will get the same. So this will not be geometrical isomerism. So only one here. So two, and one total is 5. Is it clear? Yes or no?
The ring expansion or anything is not possible.
In E2 elimination, there is no possibility of the carbocation formation. No?
You see, you are using alcohol here.
Oh, yeah, sorry,
it's an E2 elimination. Okay?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Let's go to ask doubts, questions. Okay. Whatever you think that might be there in your mind, you should ask. Okay? This is the point of paper discussion. It's not me telling you the answers. It's about you asking whatever is in your mind. Okay? Relevant to the questions. Okay, 71 and 72 is done. 73, 74, and 75. 73. 73.
Sir.
Okay, in 73, you see, in 73, I don't know anything. So, you see, you have A, which is Linda's catalyst is what? Is H2PD in presence of BaCO3 or BaSO4 dot sulfur. Okay. So this will be doing, give, converting what? An alkyne into cis alkene. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I know this much. Now this B on reaction with HCl will give a chloride. C should be a chloride. And this chloride on reaction with sodium in ether will give D. Okay. So D will be something like an alkane, because this is Wood's reaction and it should be a symmetrical alkane, right? Its molecular weight is 86. Now, if you are seeing the alkanes of the form CnH2n+2. Then if you put C is equal to 5 and H is equal to 12, you will be getting what? You will be getting molecular weight 72. Yes or no? If I put C6H14, then the molar mass will be 86. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this means that D is what? C6H14. Yes or no? Now, corresponding to this, only two configurations are possible. One is an open chain configuration and another is a branched configuration. Yes or no? Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you see, if I'm talking about C, C should be something like this. So what are the possibilities for C? Three possibilities are chlorine or chlorine. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now C is coming from HCl addition of cis alkene. So you see, if you are having a three carbon alkene, it will be something like this. So B should be something like this. There is no other way of writing propene. Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
This is retrosynthesis. You are going backwards. Now, if I'm adding HCl, I should be getting this. This is not possible. Yes or no? Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
If this is B, then what is A? A is something like CH3, C triple bond CH. Yes or no? This on H2 Lindlers will be giving this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And if this is the case, its molar mass is how much? It's 40. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If that is 40, this means that X is 4. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So is it clear? You have to go backwards. You see, these type of questions used to come when I was giving the exam. You know, we were the last batch to give the subjective name. There they used to ask this type of questions. So we write the flow diagram. This is the flow diagram. And we start with a clue. Okay, so the clue here was like alkane with a molecular weight 86. then limited amount of only one alkane is suiting that description. From that you start going backwards. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
That's good. Now after 73, is 74 and 75 also doubt?
So
75, you see, if you are doing oxidation of this, so you see first you will be getting SCHO, but you are having K1O4, so it will be oxidized to CO2 and H2. So all the terminal parts of alkene will be oxidized to CO2. I have given this point now in the class course also. If you have this and you are doing oxidative ozonolysis, then what will happen? First, you'll be getting RCHO plus H. But since you are using an oxidizing agent, this will be converted into aldehyde, will be converted into carboxylic acid, and this will be converted into something like this. It will be giving H2O plus CO2. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So acidified KMnO4 or oxidative ozonolysis, all will be giving almost similar type of products. Okay. After this, is 74 also doubt? In 74, you see, basically you are having this. So if you are doing bromine 2 moves, okay, then you see it will be under giving anti-addition.
Yes.
Okay. So anti-addition means what? Either up, down, or down up. Is it clear? So I'm drawing just one configuration. Okay. Now, if I am saying that this one is this side is up, the bromine this side will do what?
Down.
Like in this side, you can have independent configuration. So again, let us say that here, if the configuration is up, then here the configuration will be what?
Down.
Okay, now you see, what are the combinations? Alkene 1 and alkene 2. So, you see, bromine configurations are, first is up, down, and up, down, yes or no? This is the combination,
yes.
up, down, right? What else can be the configuration? If I'm starting with a down bromine, this will be up, this can be up, down. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And third one is down, up, and down, up. But then down, up will be same as up, down, because the ends are symmetrical. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is a repetition of this. Last one is what? Down, up. Oh, sorry.
Up, down.
Up, down. And down. So total unique combination is 1, 2, and 3.
Sir?
Yeah.
Last one will be repetition of second.
Sir, the third one from up, I mean from the starting, the down up, that one, the down one is the N bromine this time, no sir? So it's not different.
What?
Like the first bromine will be down this time, no sir?
The first bromine will be down.
Like if we do the numbering from left side, the first bromine initially.
I am taking it from one side, okay, and then I am doing the thing. So you see, up, down will be one. Down, up, down will be another. Up, down, up will be third. If you are looking from this side, up, down, up, and from this side also, it will be up, down, down, up. up down, up down. Are you getting a point? So both will be looking similar. Are you getting a point?
Yeah, okay, sir.
Other people clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can also draw corresponding configuration for 1, 2, and 2 and 3 to see how they are different. Is it clear? Okay. So all the numerical value questions are done. I think only numerical value question. Yeah, 10 minutes.
In this question, sir, 74th, down up, up down, and up down, down up, both will be similar on Linux.
Down up, up down. Okay, let us draw. You know, it will be better if I draw it. Okay, this is the thing. Okay, you are saying down up. Okay, also I am drawing. Okay, you just draw it. You will get the idea. So you are saying down up, up down. No, so this is down. Up. Okay, and then this is what?
Up, down.
Up, down. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
And now I'm drawing the second case. It's up, down. And okay, is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes,
I
mean, sir.
You see, essentially, this is not a chiral center, so we are looking at this and this. Okay, because rotation about this bond is possible. So basically, we are focusing on this. These two are down, down, up, up. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So in this case, if you are drawing the, let me check. Okay. If you're drawing the thing, then we were getting a CH2Br here. These two are chiral centers, right? These are the only two chiral centers. Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and then you have CH2, CH2. And then again you are having... Now you see, if I am rotating it like this, then this Br is going to come this side. This will be H. And this VR is going to come this side. This is H. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
So are you able to see how these two will be mirror images of each other? If you are drawing this one, you'll be getting something like this. Okay, again, if you are rotating it like this, this is a CH2Br, this Br will be on this side, H, then CH2. Okay, then again, this time this Br will be on this side. Are you getting a point? Yes or no? So these two are mirror images of each other. So this is D, this is L. So they are separate. Are you getting a point? They are enantiomers. Is it clear? If you draw for these two, first and third, for this and this, these two are meso. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This will be meso. So that is how you'll be drawing. There are only two chiral centers, so only three isomers will be possible. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 74 is clear to all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is done. 71 is done. Okay. Now going backwards, I don't think there is any doubt in these type of questions. 68 to 70.
So 68.
69.
Yeah. 68, they are asking kinetically controlled products. So it will be 1, 2 addition. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And after that...
Sir, 69.
You will be having...
Option A, sir.
Yeah, it is...
Sorry, not option A, option 4.
Why are you... Focus on this one. It will be alkoxy mercuration, demercuration. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, after 69.
Sir, 66.
Sir, that
option A.
This is simply nickel hydrogenation, H2Na. Are you getting your mind?
Okay, sir.
This is, I don't, okay. So now you can do it?
Yes, sir.
Sir, 62.
Any doubt from 64 to 67?
No, sir.
Then 61 to
63.
62, sir. 62. 63 is also a doubt.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you see, basically, you are having an epoxide formation in the first step. Okay. So it will be like this type of thing. Okay, and then you are using H plus. So what will happen that OH plus would form, then H2 would be attacking from down. So this will be opening up. So you'll be getting a, what you say, anti addition of OH. So if one OH is up, another OH is down. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Apart from this?
62, sir.
Yeah, sir.
62. 62. Yeah. In 62, assume that both reactions are E1, means carbocation formation is taking place. Okay. And if carbocation formation is taking place, okay, then whether you are having CH, okay, KH by KD ratio will be rising close to 1. Okay, see, if you are having a carbocation, and you have a carbocation like this, which one will be stabilized more by hyperconjugation?
The first one.
First one, plus H will be more, because hydrogens will be, the CH bond is, you know, can be broken easily in this case, facilitating hyperconjugation, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in such case, KH will be slightly greater than equal to KD. Are you getting a point? Yes or no? This is what we call as 2-degree kinetic isotope effect. Are you getting a point? If substituting hydrogen by deuterium leads to, you know, slightly less stability of carbocation, the rate of reaction will decrease slightly. Are you getting my point? So in that case, KH by KD will be slightly greater than 1. Getting my point?
Sir, we can say KH is greater than KD, but whether the ratio, like how...
It's slightly greater. So that is why it is nearly equal to 1. Okay, this part we'll be discussing mainly in aromatic compounds. Are you getting a point? So you see, there is a 1 degree kinetic isotope effect. Okay, which says that if CH bond is broken in rate determining step, okay, then replacing hydrogen by deuterium will decrease the rate of reaction drastically by 4 to 8 times. Okay, so that is, so in that case you see a huge, so KH by KD in this case will be, you know, slightly in the ratio of, you know, 4 to 8 or 4 to 10 times. Are you getting my point? But in 2-degree kinetic isotope effect, it is nearly equal to 1. Because the carbocation stability is slightly affected if you are replacing hydrogen by deuterium. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Sir, what's the basic difference between the 2-degree and 1-degree?
Basic difference is that in 1-degree kinetic isotope, the carbon-hydrogen bond is broken in the rate determining step. So if you, instead of hydrogen, if you are having deuterium, CD bond will break very slow. So the rate of reaction will decrease immediately. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
That's why you'll get a something between 3 to 8 or 4 to 8, something like that. So in all E2 elimination, okay, in all E2 elimination, the carbon-hydrogen bond is breaking in the rate determining step. Yes or no? So all will be showing 1-degree kinetic isotope effect. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. But in case of E1 elimination, the carbon-hydrogen bond is broken in the fast step. I have given this. Right?
Yes, sir.
So in that case, it will not show 1-degree kinetic isotope effect, but since the carbocation intermediate is formed, okay, it will show 2-degree kinetic isotope effect. Okay, so wherever carbocation intermediate is formed in rate determining step, it will show 2-degree kinetic isotope effect. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll be having more examples of this in the coming. Okay, so this is done. After 60? 61. Yeah, 61 should not be an issue. I have told you that the epoxide oxygen comes from this one. I have given the mechanism also, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Answer will be 1 only. 60 is done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, 59.
No, sir.
No, 58. No doubts.
No, sir. No doubt, sir. Huh? Wouldn't there be rearrangement in 59th?
No, it's E2 elimination. No? There's no scope of an rearrangement in E2.
Yes, okay.
This one?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No. Okay. Then 56 and 57.
Sir, in 57, like, should, I mean, I did it like based on steric hindrance for that edge, whichever is leaving. So I thought the one which can be easily removed, then that it will depend upon that.
So, no, if it was something like this, okay. Then for this, the rate of reaction will be very less. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
When you have a tertiary butyl group close to a beta hydrogen, then it's the steric factors will come into play. Okay, but at this beta hydrogen, what are the groups? Only CH3 is there, no? There's no steric imprint here.
Yeah, okay, sir.
Okay, that is the only thing. Okay, I think other things are easy for you people. There's anything to discuss in 57?
No, sir.
No, sir.
That's good. Then this leads to 54, 55, 56.
56, sir.
56. You see, they're asking which of them is not possible. This is something which we have discussed like in doubts also yesterday. If you have cyclohexene and you are treating it with bromine. Okay. First, you'll be getting what? Cyclic bromonium ion. Yes or no? And then, depending on what you are using. See, brine means NaCl, aqueous NaCl. So you have NaCl aqueous. Okay. This means what are the nucleophiles which are available to you? Cl minus. H2O, and obviously Br minus. Okay, so depending on which one is attacking, you can get Br. This, if Br is up, then this will be down. It is Cl, Br, or OH. So answer is 4. Is it clear? There should be,
yes, at least one problem.
So 54, 55. No doubts?
54, sir.
54. See, you have bromine here. And yeah, they are saying that what is the best way of getting alkene out of this? Bromine and? This is a 3-degree hydrogen, right? Okay. So, but you're not getting one thing. There should be something like a multiple bond here. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So if that is the case, it is a case of Hofmann's elimination. So the less substituted hydrogen and bromine should go out. All the other three will be giving side Jeff products. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, this is going to be deleted because of print error. None of the options are correct.
So, yes. Like if the base is more bulkier, we always prefer Hofmann elimination rate?
Yes.
Okay.
If the base is more bulky, or the leaving group is poor, or the beta hydrogen is sterically hindered due to a tertiary butyl group at alpha at nearby it, in all these cases, Hofmann's elimination is preferred.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
So
what is the answer for 56?
56. The answer is 4. This one is not possible. Well, there is no Br here.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, in 54th, can you suggest the reagent if you want a more substituted alkene?
All the three, 1, 2, 4, they will be giving a set of more substituted alkene only. Okay. Even We'll also give SageF an E2 with smaller base. That's good. And good living group. This will also give SageF. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is the case. After that.
So 53.
Okay. Yeah.
Sir, not one. I mean, first option.
53. See, succinic acid is this. So dipotassium succinate, if you are doing a Colbase electrolysis, you will break this bond, put a dot and dot, dot and dot. So you'll be getting CH2, CH2, dot and dot, which is ethene. Getting a point? And on the, this is the product and anode oxidation is taking place. Are you getting a point? See, what are the reactions in Colbase electrolysis? I'm just giving you. You see, you have RCO minus. At anode, always oxidation takes place. So what will happen? This will lose an electron. So you get RCOO dot plus electron. And this will give R dot plus CO2. Getting a point? This will break dot and dot. Okay, this is the reaction at anode. What is the reaction at cathode? Cathode, what happens? Oxidation takes place, right? So oxidation of what will take place? H2O will be oxidized. Sorry, at cathode reduction takes place. Sorry, anode oxidation, cathode reduction. So H2O plus electron will be getting H2 plus 2H minus. Are you getting a point? Basically, H2O consists of H plus and OH minus. It's a cation which will be getting oxidized, reduced. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yeah, okay, sir.
H plus is getting to H2. Okay, 53 is done, giving rise to 51 and 52.
52, sir.
Yeah, in 52, you have what you call as poor living group. Okay. But if you see, this poor living group will be having like different types of groups. So you are having, okay, I'm just writing it in a bigger way. So you have nitrogen. One is something like this, another is CH3, okay. Another is something like 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. And another is something like this. Are you getting a point? Now, what are the beta hydrogens? This is alpha, this is beta. This does not have any beta hydrogen. This is alpha. This is alpha, this is beta. Are you getting a point? So the least hindered beta hydrogen will go out. This will go out. What is the 1 degree beta hydrogen? This is 2 degrees. Okay, this is also 2 degrees. The answer is option 2. Getting a point? Yes or no? This
yes, sir.
This is basically heat. Okay.
So we even have a tertiary hydrogen, right?
Where do you have a tertiary? Yeah, this is a tertiary hydrogen. Thanks for spotting it. Is it good? No? But we are looking for the least hindered hydrogen. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So 52 is clear to all of you? Yes or no?
Yes,
sir.
So this gives rise to 51. Is there any doubt in 51?
Sir, in the second 52nd case, I'm always getting confused whether we take less hindered or the more stable alkene.
See, basically less hindered hydrogen, or which gives the best carbon atom. Because it goes through Hofmann's elimination. Goes through E2 mechanism with carbon and transition state. So that hydrogen whose removal will give the best carbon ion will give the E2 Hofmann's elimination. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Is it clear to all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, if we get the conjugation in the ring, would it prefer the other hydrogen?
Yeah, if there is a conjugation in the ring, then it can prefer the other hydrogen. Yes.
Then would it be the major product or the less hindered?
Then it will be the major product.
Okay, sir.
Okay, generally the less substituted hydrogen gives a better carbon ion because you have what you say as 1 degree carbon ion being more stable. Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
But if there is a conjugation stability to the carbon, then that will be preferring it. Is it clear?
Clear, sir.
Okay, so 51 is not a doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So I guess we have discussed all the questions. Yes or no?
Yes.
Any doubt in any of the questions? Last time I'm asking you.
Sir, can you once again explain 62?
62. Yeah. In 62, you see, what I have told you people is that if the carbocation is formed in a redetermining step, okay, then is stability will decide the rate of reaction? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Is stability will be more if hyperconjugation is more? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And that will be more if hydrogen is there instead of deuterium?
Yes, sir.
If we substitute deuterium by hydrogen, then the stability of carbocation will slightly decrease due to slightly less hyperconjugation?
Yes, sir.
So if the stability of carbocation is slightly decreasing, then the rate of reaction will also slightly decrease.
Yes, sir. Okay.
KH will be slightly more than KD.
Yes, sir.
So KH by KD is slightly greater than equal to 1.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Other people, are you getting this logic? Yes or no? Yeah.
Can you explain what KH and KD actually mean?
These are rate of reactions, so rate constants of the reaction.
Okay, sir.
Okay. What is exactly rate constant? It is something which tells you how fast the reaction is going for a given concentration. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, that is the case. Okay. I think everything else I have discussed, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so with this, I'm
So 72, can you suggest it for 4 also?
See, it's Take not two. About me suggesting anything. Okay. In 74, answer will be 3 only.
72, sir.
72, you are saying 2 or 4? See, 4. If the number of moles of optically inactive products is there, then only the answer can be 4. You have answered 4.
Yes, sir, because they didn't mention different types of inactive products.
But see, okay, we'll see. Maybe they can use four. Two or four, I think. Okay, I will look into it. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Any other issue in this paper?
No.
Okay. Then I would suggest that you know, do the practice. Okay. When is the exam tomorrow?
10:20.
Okay. So do the practice. Okay. Go to the advanced assignment which I have given. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So with this, I'm ending today's paper discussion. Is it okay? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's been a long day. Okay, take some rest. Okay, if you want, you can do some revision or, you know, some questions. Okay, obviously, number of questions in advanced assignment is way too much. Okay, so you do whatever you feel is good. Okay, if you have done two or three assignments, it's more than sufficient. Is it clear? So from my side, I have given all the assignments which I was having in all the previous papers. You can do any combination. Are you getting my point? So the idea is that if you go through those type of questions, you will be feeling comfortable with the questions which are asked in these papers. I hope that everyone is feeling comfortable. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us meet on Monday for the advanced paper discussion, right? I think next week the syllabus is alkynes, most probably. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll look into it.
Sir, okay? Don't you discuss paper on Sunday?
You want me to discuss?
Yes, right? Sir. So that we can get more time for next class.
Sunday, I think, I don't know my plans of evening. That's why I can't say. Okay, so now we are live and today we are going to discuss the paper WTA 21, which is based on alkenes. Okay, so this is a mains paper and it will be having like three sections. Section one will be single correct choice. Okay, and then section two will be one or more options, multi correct. And section three, which is paragraph type. So this is a paper in front of you. And we are going to discuss the whole paper. Okay, so question number 19 and 20. Any doubts? 19 is a doubt. Yeah. So in 19, basically, you have to write all possible products. So this is a major product, most substituted alkene. And then you have like minor trans cis and this one, the terminal. And then you have to do bromine and carbon tetrachloride. The trans and this is anti, so you'll be getting meso. Okay, here you'll be getting D plus L, and here also you'll be getting a chiral center, so D plus L. So 2+2+1 = 5. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 20th. It's clear. A scopes elimination. So it will be a sin elimination. So hydrogen which is up is going to go out. Are you getting a point? So the answer is B. Is it clear? The less substituted hydrogen is going to go in scopes elimination because the transition state will have a carbon ion type of character. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 21, 22, any doubts? 21, 22.
21.
21, you see, terpenolene on ozonolysis is giving this. Terpenolene is on H2PD is giving this type of alkene. It is having a ring. This means that the double bond will be somewhere inside the ring. Okay, so if you see the double bond of positions, and you join 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Joining 1 in 6 will give you a, what is it, 6-membered ring. So if you join it like this, you'll be getting it. Are you getting a point? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 and 6 are connected by a double bond. So we have drawn it like this. Okay. And then at 4th, you are having a double bond connected to two CH3 groups. And at 1, you have an extra CH3 group. This is the structure. Are you getting a point? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Alternatively, you can also do the ozonolysis and check. Right. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So you'll be getting acetone only in case of A and B, out of which case of B, you will get a 6-membered ring with 2 double bonds. B cannot be answer B. 22 is a doubt. 22 is a doubt. Yes, no.
No, sir.
That's good.
No, sir.
Yeah. This I think I have discussed in the doubts also. As far as I remember. It was a part of a multi question, like integer type questions. One of them was this. Okay, anyways.
24.
See, first you'll be getting a radical here. English can give this radical also. Okay. So here the attack can take place from up as well as down. You can get a BR up and a BR down. The here attack, here you'll be getting CH2BR. So this is also possible. And the transsynthesis version is also possible. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, in 23rd, actually, even C is possible, no? I mean, C can be the answer, right?
1 minute. Yes? What are you saying?
23 in B. In C.
Let's see. 1C-butadiene. Yeah. So you're doing HCl. Okay. So minus plus. Okay. So one product you'll be getting will be chlorine here, hydrogen here, and chlorine here. And another you'll be getting is hydrogen here. Chlorine here. Yeah. Two. Yeah. At lower temperatures, it is asking what is correct at lower temperatures. At lower temperatures, kinetic control is favored.
Okay, like that also. Yeah, okay. Yes, sir. I marked B only. I was just asking if C is also correct.
This statement is important.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay. After this, 25. Is 25 a doubt? Yes or no?
Sir, actually, 25, the pictures are not that here.
Yeah, but now it is clear now. Can you tell me? Is there any doubt in 25? Rates of hydrogenation will be maximum in case of which of the following agents? Using Wilkinson's catalyst. It will be directly proportional to the inversely proportional to the what is this? Steric crowding. Okay, so here there are two groups. Okay. Steric crowding. There is two groups at trans, and then there is one group here. So three, this double bond is substituted by three. So answer is 1 > 2 > 3. Is it clear? Are you getting a point? 25. I think I've given this statement in the notes. Rate of hydrogenation is inversely proportional to steric crowding in case of Wilkinson's, or in fact any catalytic hydrogenation. Okay. 26, 27. Is it a doubt?
Sir, 26.
26, I have given the... Okay. You see... Suppose you have RCH2Cl. And you treat it with P5-3. Then what will happen that this will go out? You get RCH2P5-5. And then you use a carbonyl R dash minus. Then it will take the beta hydrogen, so the alpha hydrogen. And you will be getting R CH minus. This is a plus. Okay, so this is the what it says phosphorus violet. Okay, or sometimes it is can also be written as RCH double bond P Y five. Okay, now this, when it is treated with a R dash C double dash so on O, then what is going to happen is that through pericyclic mechanism, it just goes out minus of P double bond O Y. And you will be getting R CH double one C R dash R double dash. Are you getting a point? Yes or no? So any this I have given in the notes of any alkene can be considered to be part of a carbonyl compound and a phosphorus violet. Are you getting a point? Yes, or
yes
no?
Sir.
So either you can consider this to be double bond O and this to be CL, or you can consider this to be double bond O and this to be CL. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So A and B both are correct. This is the Wittig reaction. Okay? I have given this reaction in the notes. Yes or no? So,
yes, sir.
Yeah. So 26 is done. 27. Is it out? In 27, due to the printing mistake, answer C will be incorrect. They have given alkanes. Deodation or alcohol should give alkenes. So C won't be correct. Is it clear? Answer should be A and B only. Are you getting this point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is C change. 28, 29, 30. Twenty-nine is fairly easy. You have to just look for beta hydrogen or deuterium. So you see here bromine is up. So it requires deuterium, which is down. But this side you have CH3, which is down, which cannot leave. So these two will be going out. So you get a double bond here. Are you getting a point? The answer will be this one. This is the product, so the A cannot be the other three. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 30th. 30th, you can do it by just, doing the analysis in all the four options. Okay. Or totally depends on how you want to do it. So you see, only in case of C, you'll get a single product. Are you getting a point? In all other cases, you'll be getting multiple product. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
I believe in 32, the answer should be ABCD. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
There's a key change.
Yes, sir.
If you see the rearrangement and then write the product, you'll get answer to the C. 31 is not a doubt.
Option C.
Option C. In presence of H2O2 and peroxide and HNO, we undergo anti-Markovnikov offs. This is plus, this is minus. This plus, okay, this is minus. So 32 is done? 31, 32? Yes or no?
Yes.
People feeling yes. Sleepy. Continuous classes are there. Okay.
We had Sanskrit class, sir.
Yeah,
4:30.
Okay, it's okay. I can understand. Okay, 33, 34. 34 is again a question which is, I think, asked earlier also. Exactly the same question is there.
Yes, no doubts.
34 is repeated?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 35, 36. Benzene will not.
35, sir.
Yeah. You see, benzene will not react with. Will not give the bromine water test as well as KMnO4 oxidation. Are you getting a point? Because of its aromatic nature, it is very less reactive towards any of these reagents. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
Sir, what about option C?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Option C. Option C, bromine, carbon, tetrachloride. Okay. Yeah, option C will be giving two products for A. Are you getting a point? It is saying that A with KMnO4 is giving only one product.
Sir, no, KMnO4 means he's considering ozonolysis.
Oxidative ozonolysis product, you can write.
Sir, we can think of that that OH-OH addition, sir.
No, if nothing is mentioned, then you have to take the that product. Oxidative osmolysis.
He did not mention anything.
But yeah, they have not mentioned it. So yeah. 35 should go.
In the paragraph, I think he gave addition of two OH groups, sir.
Okay. Yeah, see, if they have given the syn hydroxylation, then you see it will create two products now. Because this will become a chiral center.
Oh, yeah, okay, sir.
So, still, so yeah, 35 answer cannot be C in any case. Getting your point?
Okay, sir.
36. Is it out?
Explain.
Yeah. You see, 36, you have this compound. Okay, so this can be up as well as down, but when you're doing KNO4OH minus cold, then you'll be getting these two, we don't know, but this would be either up or these two can be either down. Are you getting a point? Yes or no? Yes or no?
So there's two methyl groups in the second one, right?
1 minute. Yeah. Okay. Now here we can talk about the orientation of these two loops. So either it can be both up or can be both down. See, these two orientations would be same. See, here it is OH. Yes, or there is a third option, which is something like this.
Sir, all the four are chiral centers, no, sir?
Yeah. But you see, I will discuss it. Okay. You can have one OH up. So one CH3 up, down, and one up, okay. Only these three possibilities are there, yes or no? One down, one up, or up, down, both are same. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
No. I think one more option is there. There is one more option. which okay, these are the four options here. Okay, this will be meso, right? This is also meso, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, but and if you're talking about this, this is also meso.
Sir, last one not seen.
No, this is not meso because you have CH3 and OH, right? So this will be chiral, yes or no? So if this is D, then this is L. Can I say that?
Yes, sir.
If you put a mirror here, then this and this will be mirror image, this and this, this, this. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us come to this side. Now you see, this side will be getting the same compounds. Okay. So let us see. First one. This is OH and OH, OH. Okay, so first all four OH, all four are down. Okay, now this is, if this is A, this is also A, yes or no? If I just flip it about 180 degrees,
yes,
I will get this molecule. Yeah. Yes? Okay. Second is I put this up and this up. This down. This down. If I say this is B and I flip it 180 degrees, I will get this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So these two are not extra. These have already been counted. Okay. Third one. Let us talk about which and which. Now you see, I can put this up, this down, right? Now this will be identical to which one?
B.
Okay, so this is, let us say this is P and this is Q. Then this is identical to Q. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If I rotate it to 180 degree, I will get Q. This up will go down. This down will go up. And the last one, if I okay. Now this time I am putting this to be in this to be, this is identical to P. If I rotate this by 180 degrees, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So again, these two are, yes, have already been counted. The answer is 4. Yes or no?
So once, can you say like how you're writing P and Q, like that L form from D?
No, see, I have already drawn P and Q here. Now, this P is identical to this. How? You see, three up and one down, and you just 180 degree rotate it, you'll get this form.
No, sir. I mean, the mirror image, how you're writing, the L form of D. That mirror image part, I'm not understanding how you exactly.
See, in mirror image, what we do, we exactly inverse the configuration along each carbon?
Yes, sir.
So if we are inverting, I'm getting this. Here I'm inverting, I'm getting this. Here I'm inverting. Okay, let me...
Those OH groups will also be down, no, sir?
No. Let me... If you draw the mirror image of this, you'll get this. That is the best way of explaining it. Are you getting a point? You want to draw? It will be easier if you draw it yourself. You have placed the meter here. What is the meter image? This.
Yeah, okay, sir.
This. So this is D, this is L. Okay? Getting my point? Yes or no? So 36 answer is 4.
Okay. So when you are like rotating 180, the every group which is up, it changes to down.
Yeah. And every group which is down is going to up.
Then like how this here Q and Q are similar, sir?
This and this.
Yes, sir.
See, if you are rotating 180, this is down. This becomes up. Sorry.
It should be like similar with P, which you have written in the left.
Yeah, you have written it. So if you are rotating it like this, then this is P only. This is Q. Getting a point? If you are rotating it like this, this goes down. So this group, which is up here, on 180 degree, see, on 180 degree rotation, what happens? Up becomes down, right becomes left, and vice versa. So this is what? This is on the upright. Yes. It becomes down left.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Now you are clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other doubts? In this paper, any other doubts are there? I think it is fairly simple paper. Yes. Can you be more clear?
So once again, can you say 25th between 2 and 3?
25th. See, there are like double bond, it is having three groups. There are only two groups are there. There are only two groups are there. But both groups are CH2 here it is CH3 and C2H5. Okay.
Yeah, okay, sir.
So that is done. Any other doubt? Is there any other doubt in this doubt in paper? Okay. So I think the paper discussion is fairly over from my side. Okay. I'm just pausing the recording now.